So another pathological variation is the hypotension. So hypotension is the decrease the blood pressures. So decrease the blood pressure, this also two types of the blood pressures. So this is the primary hypotension and also secondary hypotension. So primary hypotension means there is no proper cause to factor, same like the hypertension. So this is also no reason, but they are going to get the less blood pressures. So this is called as essential hypotension. So another one is going to be the secondary hypotension. Secondary hypotension is due to the causative factor, is a known causative factors. So known causative factors are the main known causative factors, the myocardial infarction, that is the decrease of blood circulation to the heart muscles, and also hypoactivity of the pituitary gland. Pituitary gland is the master gland of our body. So if any hypoactivity, there is no activity, if the function is less, so it may chance to get the blood pressure, low blood pressures. And also hypoactivity of the adrenal gland. So if you know no proper secretion of the adrenaline, and also infection, tuberculosis infection, and nervous disorders. So if any neurological disorders, so may chance to get the hypotension, that is the decrease the blood circulations. So this also same like the hypertension, two types, primary hypotension, and also secondary hypotension. Primary, there is no known cause factor, but these people are going to face the like always tiredness and weakness. But if they take rest, again, they are going to get the normal. But only thing is, one more important factor is orthostatic hypotension. This is the major complications it may give the health issues. So sometimes the person may chance to get the giddiness, may fall down. Because of these things, may chance to get the head injuries. What is the orthostatic hypotension? Orthostatic hypotension is sudden fall in the blood pressure while standing for some time. If, for example, this is most commonly seen in the bedridden patients. If any patient complete bedridden on the bed continuously because of the spinal cord injury, the person unable to sit, unable to stand, unable to walk, so continuously on the bed. If suddenly the patient get up from the bed to and sitting pose, or if someone make them into the standing pose, automatically they are going to get the giddiness. Why? So continuous bed sleeping on the bed or supine lying positions, the blood flow will be altered. The pressure going to be altered. If they get up, the blood has to pump against the gravity. So in the standing position, blood has to pump upwards. So it's a difficult. So the blood circulation is going to be decreased. So this condition is called as orthostatic hypotension. So this condition most commonly seen in the myasthenia gravis and also neurological disorders who are on the bedridden and tabes dorsalis, syringomyelia and diabetic neuropathy. So these conditions maybe you will learn in the next further semesters. You can learn clearly in the detail in the next semesters. So that's all about the today topic. So these are the major the examinations of the vital signs. So blood, first one is the body temperatures, pulse rate, respiratory rate, and also blood pressures. Here I explained a little bit detail. So why you have to differentially diagnosis. This is very, very important. If anybody comes with a known cause factor or unknown cause factor, you have to differentiate. That is the importance of the diagnosis. If you diagnose properly, so then only can give the treatment properly. We can give the treatment properly. So that is the reason here I explained clearly about the what type of the pathological changes, how it's going to be altered, what are the cause to factor. Hopefully you understand about the vital signs examinations. If you have any doubts, you can send a message. I can clarify your doubts. No worries. Thank you very much. That's all about your topic.